plants do something more exotic. They take carbon dioxide from the air and combine it with many protons and many electrons net to make sugar. So it's very exciting. They're actually pretty good at it, obviously. They've been around for a few billion years. What's really interesting about the way plants do that is that if you look in Connecticut at a forest or in a mountainside in Switzerland or near where I'm from in Kansas, you see green everywhere. So inside green leaves, there's biological machinery that's driving these processes. And it's really very beautiful machinery where light energy is absorbed and passed between various light-absorbing units and then passed to a reaction center where we try to drive this chemistry with light energy. And so chemists have become very good at understanding how all these biological machines work together to drive these reactions. And that's one thing that Harry Gray has built his career on, is understanding how the electrons and protons can move through these systems to take low energy water, to liberate oxygen, and then send that those electrons up to make essentially the biological equivalent of hydrogen that the plants can use later. So what we need to learn to do is to take inspiration from nature. We have to be bio-inspired. We have to learn from this process, which is very complicated and relies on biology on the left, and create artificial systems that can do that. Artificial photosystems, using things like semiconductors and electrochemical cells and things that Amanda and Bob are going to tell you about. With the idea that we can use light energy to take water to make oxygen. And we're not alone in doing this. There are many efforts back where I'm from at Yale, here at Caltech, Arizona State, Penn State, all over the world. Catalyst, we believe. Nature found one solution to this problem, one solution to water today, in 3 billion years, we think, to make oxygen. So why don't you all just go do that this school year? You can't. It's not. We have this idea from plants of metal oxides. Well, we can make our own metal oxides, which is what you do in this program. You take metal salts, and you bake them, and you make metal oxides, which have unique combinations. And what we're betting on is that you'll find a very special combination, just like plants did, with actually manganese and calcium. to split water. With that, I'll just say it's time to go.